Hello folks, back in June, reliable tipster Digital Chat Station claimed that the Snapdragon Agent 2 will come in a 1+2+2+3 CPU configuration comprising one Cortex-X3, two Cortex-A72, two Cortex-A720, two Cortex-A710 and three Cortex-A510 cores. But new information that surfaced online reveals different specs. This revelation comes from another reliable tipster, Ice Universe, who said that Snapdragon Agent 2 will come with two Cortex-A715 cores instead of Cortex-A720. The Cortex-X3 will have a maximum clock speed of 3.2 GHz, whereas the Cortex-A510 will go up to 2 GHz. The Cortex-A715 and Cortex-A710 cores will be clocked at up to 2.8 GHz. The Snapdragon Agent 2 is rumored to use an Adreno 740 GPU to handle graphically intensive tasks such as gaming and video editing, but we don't have much information about that yet. We've also heard rumors of the Snapdragon Agent 2 having an ultra-high frequency variant, whose prime core will be clocked at 3.4 to 3.5 GHz. To give you a bit of comparison, the Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 has a prime core clocked at 3.2 GHz, while the A16 Bionic on the iPhone 14 Pro and Pro Max has a performance core clocked at 3.46 GHz. With Qualcomm believed to be focusing on energy efficiency rather than performance with the Snapdragon Agent 2, the ultra-high frequency version of the chipset would be of interest to manufacturers looking for a chip that will emphasize power over efficiency. The Snapdragon Agent 2 chip will supposedly be produced by TSMC using its 4 nanometers process node. This is the chip that is expected to power variants of the Samsung Galaxy S23 series regardless of which market they are sold in. Traditionally, Samsung uses the latest high-end Snapdragon chip on the Galaxy S series in markets such as the US and China, with the Exynos chips used in all other markets. But back in June, wary of issues with a 5G modem integrated with the Exynos 2300. Reliable TF International analyst Minchu Kuo said that the Snapdragon Agent 2 will power all Galaxy S23 phones next year. We will see if he is right sometime in January. There is no word from Qualcomm about the Snapdragon Agent 2 yet, but the American chip company is hosting the Snapdragon Summit between November 15th to 17th in Hawaii, where it will likely introduce the flagship chip. Recently, we saw the price of the Pixel 7, and today is the Google Pixel Watch's turn. Per Roland Kwan, who shared the Pixel 7's European price, Google's first smartwatch will cost £339 in the UK for a Wi-Fi-only model. That would translate to a likely starting price of €379 in Europe and possibly €419 for the LTE model. That's a similar price to the Galaxy Watch 5. Google will give the full details of the Pixel Watch at its October 6th event next week. The watch will come in three colors. At the center, it will have a circular OLED screen with rounded edges, a Samsung Exynos 9110 chipset, a Cortex M33 coprocessor, 1.5 or 2 GB of RAM, 32 GB of storage, and a 300 mAh battery, and will naturally boot Wear OS. The Xiaomi 12T series is launching on October 4th, and ahead of the big reveal, CEO Lei Zhang took to Twitter to confirm one of the key upgrades over the 12S series, a 200-megapixel main camera sensor. Based on the most current leaks, we expect only the Xiaomi 12T Pro to get the huge sensor, while Xiaomi 12T will make do with a 108-megapixel main shooter. Xiaomi 12T Pro is rumored to use Samsung's HP1 sensor. The same 200-megapixel sensor is used in the Motorola Edge 30 Ultra. The rest of the rumored specs for the Xiaomi 12T series include 6.67 AMOLED displays, 5000 mAh batteries with 112W fast charging, Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 chipset for the 12T Pro, and MediaTek's Dimensity 8100 for the Xiaomi 12T. Guys, this was the most interesting news for today. We will continue to keep you updated. Thanks for watching. Good luck, everyone.